Never been to Gwydor in Donegal. We went there when I was 12. It was this big cross-country race for all the lads. The next thing we're in a minibus heading towards Derry one morning. And this is huge. And this is like international athletics for us. Because we're racing boys from the north and we have this thing to do Dublin proud. Two of the boys are prods. The rest of us are Catholics. It's a cross-community event. I suppose the good people in the north think this is great stuff. Let's get the old team on from Dublin. And all that patronising shite. Going through the border, and the boys are all singing pop tunes and all. But I'm just in the back of the bus, looking out the window. And we're going through them mountains. You know Mount Argonne, isn't it? It's a beautiful sight, Don. Donegal has to be the most beautiful place in Ireland, I reckon. So we arrive in Gwydor. What a spot. Now there's about 200 lads, and they're running around trying to get into their gear and number up. Everything decides to go for a bit of a jog, stretch out the legs. So we run down this valley of woods and a stream running through. Woods and a stream, Don. It's like the Amazon to us. So we bump into these jungles of Cork. There's a bit of banter about our accents. They could barely talk. I mean, you couldn't understand a word they were saying, you know. You get the idea they were lording over us a bit, you know. Looking down on us. I'm sensing it anyway. So they get the idea that we go down to the stream and check it out for fish. So we're down at the stream, Don. The stream, there's about half a foot of water in there. Small little silver fish, but nothing substantial. One of their boys calls us further down. Lying in the water is a young fella, 4 or 5 days old. It's flesh and bone. And has flecks of blood in its gum. Because it's cut us ever really badly on the sharp rocks. And we're all standing over him. And you can see his back leg is snapped. So this big conversation gets started up between the lads. Who now all of a sudden reckon themselves the leaders and that deliberating is what we should do. I'm looking at their faces and I can see they're either scared, stiff or fucking clueless. It's all bravado. This young fella on the ground, all this fucking shit chat going on, going nowhere. Next thing the priest sees us, sees the fella, tells us not to move what we're done for. I mean really done for. Group of boys will always get the blame for holding a young foul. Group of Dublin boys will get a hammering for sure. So it's clear to me in an instant. And I get down on my knees. And I take that young foul's head in my hands. And I put him on the water. He's trashing about a bit at the start. So I press down hard until he's drowned. Priest arrives down. Sees the fall. Comes over and he grabs me by the hair. And he's dragging me through the woods. And he's promising me a proper hiding. But I knew it did the right thing for that young fellow. I knew I could take the punishment for all our boys. I had the respect of them with our boys now when I knew that. I'm clear of all the reasons, Don. And I'm clear of all the repercussions. I will act. And I will not stand by and do nothing.